Hello and welcome to another class of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, I'm going to be taking a look at the Master Detail option within Scriptcase and showing you how to create one. But first of all, what is a master detail? A master detail is a relationship between two different applications, or the same applications even, where the master will have a one-to-many relationship. And now, what does that mean, one-to-many? It means that a single master can have many details, but a single detail can only have one master. To create a master detail relationship, we will need to have two different tables where they have some kind of relationship, such as an ID. For the purpose of this video, I will be creating a form using the order table as the master application, and then I will also create another form with the order details table. So to begin with, I will create a new form using first of all the orders table. I will go ahead, select the create and return, and then create. Then I will go ahead, deselect the create and return, select the form application again, and this time select the order details table, and I will also select the editable grid as the layout for this form. Again, I will select create, and then we have our two forms ready. So I will go ahead and generate the order details form, and then I will also access the form orders. So once both forms have been created and they are already generated, we can go ahead and access the master detail form option within the left hand menu. Here I can select the new detail, and for the name I will also include the name as details, and the label I will leave blank as it will be automatically completed from the name. And below that then I have the option to create a new block to place this field, or essentially this application which I will be linking. Once ready, I can click create. Now within the next step, I can then select the form order details, which I had previously created, and click next. The next step allows me to select the foreign key, which is associated to the other form. So here I will also associate the order ID to the order ID field, and again, click next. For the final step, we have the option to include extra parameters if we so need to. Once ready, I can click confirm. Now here we can see that we have some options available that are related to the detail form. Here I can define what will be enabled. For example, the insert, update, delete, as well as the navigation buttons, and also as the where, if we are using any such statement within our application. I can also define the iframe, width and height, as well as some further detail options. The form layout, paging, how many lines each page will have, and what will happen when I delete something. But first, okay, so I will go ahead and select save, and then we have our master detail form ready. So if I now go ahead and run the form, I will now see the default form layout as well as the order details below, and then navigating from one order to another, I will see the order details also update with the relevant information. Okay, so we may want to make some changes to this master detail layout, as we have a lot of information here that the user may not want to see. For example, those ID fields, the product ID, where we can apply lookups and actually retrieve the name of the product and display that to the end user. So let's go ahead back into Scriptcase. So I will access the fields. First we'll select the customer ID, and here I will use the automatic lookup, select the customers, save it, select my connection, and then I will also go ahead and apply the same to the employee ID. I will create here my select the employees table, indicate the first name or as well as the last name. We can add both. So let's go ahead and do that and say yes. Now here we will want to make a slight adjustment to our selection here so that we can have a space in between the two lines. Now if I go ahead and run the form, and then now we will have the first name and the last name combined for the employee ID. Let's return back to Scriptcase, and we're going to adjust some of these further fields. Now I will hide the order ID, I'll also hide the ship address, the postal code, as well as some basic details regarding the delivery address overall. So here we have, and I will move the ship name up to the top, and then we can go ahead and run the form again, and we will see that we have some differences within the application, displaying the information that we want to our end user. Okay, so now this time let's go ahead and make some changes within the detail form. So back within Scriptcase, and this time I will select the form order details. And here I want to make some adjustments to some of the information here. So for the quantity, for instance, I want to set a minimum value of 1. So once I've applied that, I then also want to change the product ID to actually display the product name. So here I will select the products table, provide the name, again select the database connection, and save the application. Now I also want to adjust the order ID so that this is displayed as a label and cannot be edited by the end user. So I will also save that. Now one final step is I want to add a new field. And with this new field, we are going to calculate some values of other available fields within this form. So here I will give it a default name of value. I will leave the text type. We can of course change this to a decimal, currency, or integer for this specific value that we want to retain. Now, once we have the field created, we can then go ahead and use the events. Now, within the events, I will select the onLoadRecord so that for each record loaded, it will then perform the calculation. So then here, I will then provide the field that I have just created, value, and the value field will then become the unit price, and then we will plus that with quantity, for instance, just as an example. And of course, we can apply any type of calculation here that we want. And now if I go ahead and generate the details form, and then I will also go ahead and run the form orders, which will at the same time generate the form. And now we will have our updated information. So if I scroll forward and edit here, we can see that the order ID is now as a label and uneditable by the user. We have our value also automatically calculated, and we have the product ID as the name defined. So once we're ready, we can then apply any other calculations or fields that we want within the two forms. So before I finish this video, let's check out this macro that can be very useful when creating a master detail relationship. The macro is called sc_master_value, and it serves to update the master detail. So if you provide any changes within the detail application, so for example, we have the total value of the order, and if I add more items to the details or change the value of any product, it should then also be reflected in the master application or form. So let's go ahead and access Scriptcase again. And here I will access the form order details. And here we have the events available. So now the SE master value macro can be used within the events on after insert, on after update, and on after delete. So all I have to do is then access the event where I want to apply it, and then simply call the macro, and the master detail will be updated when changes have been applied to the detail form. The master application will then also be updated with the relevant data. Now do note within the macro information and help, we have more information here, as well as further options that we can apply with this macro and also for our master detail form. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.